Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play World Flipper on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install World Flipper and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play World Flipper. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to get started we have to launch our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type it, because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We landed at this point on our website of Usitility, in which we have a nice meticulous outline on the way to download and install World Flipper on computer. We scroll lower a bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will run to play World Flipper on our PC. It is now obvious that we get a number of pros of preferring that emulator. Now we are ready to proceed to download the World Flipper by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. We then click on that button. And the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we are going to do now is to launch the installer, okay, then we need to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the device. We clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to see the installer better. The installer is very simple to use. It consists of two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path does indeed. We only simply click on it. So we realize that we get here the path where in fact the emulator can be put in. If we are planning to modify this folder we have got to click on the Browse option, and we opt for another folder and set up the emulator wherever we wish. I will leave it by default. Then, I click on Back. And I just click Install. Now, there it is. The setup starts and it will progress together with the download of all these megabytes which are represented on that computer screen. When you download it, it could possibly be slightly more or less megabytes. The download rate will go faster or slower, subject to your type of connection and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they are progressing really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator happens to be launched automatically. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right when it has reached the finish, the emulator can be started for the first time. In reality the emulator has been launched, here it is for the very first time. Before we continue, as now you can see, it has created two app icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the only one we are focused on. Anytime we would like to launch World Flipper on the desktop or laptop, we twice click this particular icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we conduct the next step, which is a must-have, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is started. Here we have to log on. At this moment once we are here, we must definitely begin doing this following step that is imperative. Therefore we just click on Sign In. At this moment it shows Checking Info. It can sometimes get stopped at Checking Info, and so it fails to progress. If so, you may try to log in after a number of hours but it will surely most probably be resolved. At this moment we can enter our username and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For example, you could use the same email you use at this moment in your YouTube account. Thus, I will insert my data and I'll go back as soon as I have accomplished it. That's it, info entered. This is Google welcoming us and supplying us the twos. We can approve them all simply by pressing, I agree. Following, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and this will build a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We click accept. Google Play is started by default and automatically. To set up the app, we would need to visit the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon marked green colored. Right now that we are discovering the desktop of the emulator, we notice that we come with there the install application option. We then click on the button. There we come with the game. So let's mouse click there on the install choice that I am showing now in green color. And this will launch the installation. At this moment it would install the video game, it could take quite some time or it may just be very fast. It again all is going to depend on our own connection to the internet. It's just finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this button I'm presenting in green, if you want to run World Flipper for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, and we're preparing to mouse click on the brand new World Flipper app icon that was created. The game app is launched for the first time. So there we get it, I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume of the emulator. This is here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. This is actually the first one, we click on that software icon which I am indeed identifying in green color. And the monitor is maximized, getting one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In case we need to appreciate the game using all the screen, we select that game icon. And we'd already be enjoying the Android game in full screen function. To get out of the 100% screen functionality, push the F11 key. And we might by now be in standard computer screen setting. At present, I am on the way to reveal you the keyboard mapping and that is really surprisingly enjoyable. That strategy we will certainly be in a position to use the game application a lot more effortlessly. The very first point is to mouse click this computer keyboard icon. And there you will have the ability to make the necessary controls. I'm going to let the standard settings, though if you prefer to adjust it, you may very well do it now without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our language. From time to time it occurs that the emulator is presented in the incorrect language, for instance, in Japanese. And then to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And there within other controls, we just click on the language drop down. We will pick the language we prefer, Italian, Chinese, and so on. Once the language is determined, we could save, the emulator will restart, and also the Android game, the next time we launch it, will of course be in the chosen language. At this moment, you can find another aspect that we must take into consideration, and it's that we will get an email telling that a completely new machine has been associated with our Google account. It will likely question us if we're the people who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we should not get worried, simply because the emulator is emulating in Google Android smartphone or tablet. In order to determine which device is being emulated, we come back here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Therefore we browse here to the model option. And here we realize that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for the tutorial. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that you thought it was informative. If that's the case, allow it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any remarks, issues or ideas, leave them in the comment box down below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams occasionally, you have it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of those videos that happens to be appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next training videos. Bye.